My name is Andres Maem. I am an independent analyst of energy policy.
Could you please describe the structure of global fuel mix?
Usually the data of International Energy Agency or global energy companies like British Petroleum or ExxonMobil is used when global energy consumption is discussed. These data may differ because of differences in statistics. Therefore, important are proportions and trends in these graphs, not the exact amounts of consumed energy. Global fuel mix represents the consumption of primary energy in the world. Primary energy means the energy found in nature that has not been subjected to any kind of conversion or transformation. According to the data of British Petroleum, fossil fuels dominate the global fuel mix with a share of almost 90%. The share of oil in global fuel mix is over 33%, coal around 30% and natural gas around 24%. Fossil fuel mix has been changing during the last 3 or 4 years. Oil is still the leading fuel, but it has lost its market share, mostly to natural gas and coal. This is caused by the fast increase in electrical energy production from coal and gas. Renewable energy sources account less than 2% of global energy consumption. Renewables are the fastest growing fuels in the world, but their share in global fuel mix will remain low. The rest, 11% of global energy mix, is covered by electrical energy produced in hydro and nuclear power plants. The main trend is overall increase in primary energy consumption despite the global recession of economy since 2009. World primary energy consumption has been growing a bit less than 2% per annum during last 10 years. Driving forces behind this increase of energy demand are emerging economies, particularly China, India and other countries in Southeast Asia. In these countries, the growth of energy demand has been over 2% during the last 10 years. China will become the biggest oil importing country and India becomes the largest coal importing country around 2020. Population and income growth drive the increase of demand of energy in China, India and Southeast Asia. Almost all energy consumption growth becomes from these countries during the next 15 years.
What is the structure of European Union's fuel mix?
The data from Eurostat has been used to describe the fuel mix of the European Union. But it has to keep in mind that the energy consumption of each member state depends on the structure of its energy system, the availability of natural resources for primary energy production, and the structure and development of each economy. The proportions and trends of EU's fuel mix are important, not the exact amounts of consumed energy, of course. Primary energy demand decreased by 5% in 2009 due to the economic recession, but in 2010 it rebounded in most of the member states with overall increase by 3%. According to the European Commission, in 2010, the fossil fuels accounted for 76% of EU's primary energy demand. The rest was covered by renewable sources and nuclear energy. Nuclear energy's share in EU's fuel mix is bigger than it is in global level. This will remain so even after the closure of nuclear power plants in Germany. There have been some important changes in the European Union's fuel mix during the last 5 years. First, there was a gradual decline in the share of oil and coal. The combined share of oil and coal fell from 57% of total consumption in 2000 to 51% by 2010, reflecting a move away from the most polluting fossil fuels. Renewable energy sources accounted for 10% of EU's energy consumption in 2010 and 2011. Electrical energy produced by hydropower plants is added to the renewables and not calculated separately as it was in the data of British Petroleum. Separately, the renewables and hydro energy will both have around 5% of market share in the EU. Renewables were the fastest growing sector of energy industry until 2009 in the EU, but due to the economical recession, some of the member states have significantly decreased subsidies to renewable energy sources. Since 2010, the coal consumption has increased in the EU due to the influx of cheap import. This was an impact of shale revolution in the United States, which caused the change in fuel mix there. Coal was replaced by shale gas in the United States and cheap coal was exported. European consumers have been interested in importing cheap coal to replace more expensive natural gas. It is predicted that coal will regain its positions in the EU's fuel mix during next coming years. Generation of electrical energy is the main field where the imported coal is used instead of natural gas, mostly in Germany and Netherlands, where new coal-based power plants have been built. Recently, Poland declared that it would continue with coal-based electricity as well. 90% of Poland's electrical energy is produced from coal.
What are the prospects for European Union energy policy?
The biggest problem for the European Union is the growing burden of fossil fuels import. EU's annual spending on foreign oil and natural gas is already more than half a trillion US dollars per year. This is expected to grow nearly 10% during next 20 years, and it will sap more than 2% of GDP of the EU by 2035. EU's fossil fuels import is well diversified, but that does not apply to all member states. An example, Central and Eastern Europe's import dependence on natural gas is less diversified than in Western Europe. There is a global market of oil and coal, which means diversity in supply of these two fossil fuels. But this is not the case of natural gas, which is still mostly supplied via pipelines. One way to diversify natural gas imports is in liquefied form, and Europe has several liquefied natural gas or LNG regasification terminals, but these are mostly located in the coasts of Western European countries. There are plans to connect existing and planned LNG terminals with Central and Eastern European gas markets via pipeline. Natural gas prices will vary across regions until more flexible supply terms develop and the global market is formed to narrow the gaps, according to the International Energy Agency. The price of natural gas in the EU is now almost twice of the price in the United States, which leaves energy-intensive industries in the EU at competitive disadvantage comparing with these in the United States. But natural gas prices in Europe are approximately twice as lower than prices in Southeast Asia. That leaves European LNG regasification terminals underutilized. It is predicted that natural gas liquefaction capacity will be doubled in the world by 2020, if compared with 2012. But there are doubts whether these new capacities will be used to supply European consumers. The price in Asia is more tempting for LNG exporters to the economic growth and increase of consumption there, which is not projected in Europe. Natural gas is a regional commodity, and lower prices in the United States, due to the shale gas boom, will not be transferred to other markets. If shale gas is exported, then transport costs will be added, and if the gas is exported as LNG, the liquefaction and regasification cost will be added as well. Secondly, natural gas for heat energy is a seasonal commodity, and therefore storing costs will be added. The European price of LNG cannot decrease either, because of the lower price level will not be encouraging for the producers or exporters. It is predicted that Europe will be the end market where LNG will be sent if there is excess of supply. Therefore, the hope for lower LNG prices in Europe is not substantiated.